Okay, we are ready. We're going into Hayward today. I did the video on going to cable the other day, which we're going to be going through cable too. But I figured this time we're heading all the way into cable, into Hayward today, so I figured I'd do a video for that. My monthly run. Make sure I got everything. Yeah, the only reason I'm going, it's like out of all of mom's medications, there's one that they will not ship, which stinks, because then I probably wouldn't have to go at all. For, I wish they would just ship it. It's like, it makes me wonder, you know, it's like, what happens for somebody that has zero way to get to town or has anybody to get the medication for them? How do they get their medication? You know? Oh, it's like we got, I don't know if that's open water right out there. Or is that water on the top of the ice? Actually, looks like it might be open. Yeah. Yeah, not. I don't usually have open water quite this early. Shoot, we should. Last year we had a couple foot of snow on the ground still by this point. Normally we would have snow on the ground at this point. Oh shoot, did I close the garage? Snowing on that at all this year. You get to do it. It's random. and that one time, if you didn't catch that video, the early season snowmobile on the lake, it was just basically shoreline, and then a lot of it I was pushing myself because it was a little bit too slushy, and I was getting bogged down. I'd use my foot to move myself, throttle up. But it's looking like the end of March is, like the last week of March, it looks like snow and cooler weather again. We are the middle of the month now already. March, what, 13th or something like that. Outside of Cable, we're going to be stopping at the Como Oil, get some fuel oil ordered for the furnace. We're down to a quarter tank. It's like the gas prices, it's like you just start getting ahead again, because I'm trying to save money, I'm trying to get money together so I can get Mom a cart that she can drive around the yard and stuff like that, so she can't walk very well anymore, so get her the cart so she can run around the yard and go down by the lake and things like that. But every time I start getting a little bit of money back, then a fuel oil bill comes up, and another $700 in fuel oil for them. And that's, this time of year, it's monthly, it seems like. And then the food and stuff, I was just talking to the lady over at the bank, because my limit for amount you can use the debit card for is not high enough for this, you know, for this run into town. So I was getting that upped, and she's like, yeah, with inflation things are crazy, you know. If we're talking about that, we're, you know, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, whatever, you know, before, I could go to town and spend $300 at the top, you know, for the stuff that I need. And that's like high end. Now, $500-$600 is the way it is now. For everything, you know, it's like you go and go to gas and you need, you know, food, and you need supplies, different things, like, you know, Kleenex and toilet paper and things like that. It all adds up quick now, especially everything's priced 3-4 times higher than it's supposed to be, which, it doesn't make sense. It's like, who's the one that's overcharging at the very beginning of the chain that is making everything? How is the one product that was $1 3 years ago, how is that dollar product worth $8 now? It doesn't make sense. It's like, well, it's like if you think back to, like, if you watch, like, things like Little House on the Prairie and things like those times, you know, they're talking about, oh my goodness, a penny for a pound of potatoes or something. It's like, oh my, penny candy and stuff. Penny candy, you get a corner of the plastic wrap that's in, the candy goes in. It's like, it doesn't make sense. It's, everything is still worth what it was back then. It's just people like to see big numbers. And unfortunately, stuff costs big numbers and still make small numbers in income. would be greatly appreciated, because I just need to get some extra income coming in for the channel so I can afford to eat. Yeah. And the channel itself is expensive to run, so. But it's the way things are. Live and live, you know. Four seasons go down that way. Such a beautiful drive. I try to look at the trees and I'll see if there's, kind of looks like, yeah, actually it looks like there's buds. Buds starting to come out of the trees. My uncle was saying yesterday that he was, got trees tapped, maple trees trapped, got like 5 gallons of sap, so cooking that down. Well, my friend was saying that he was tapping his trees February, I think he said. It was like back when we should have like still have feet of snow on the ground. Back when it was getting up into the 40s during the day, freezing at night. Gets that maple syrup flowing. Okay, well, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to listen to some music and I'm going to put some, I'll throw some music into the video from another source that I know is not copyrighted, and we'll go from there. So enjoy the trip. I'll turn this front camera that's facing me off for a little while, and we'll just flip over to the other one and do a little time lapse going into town and stuff. So, okay, well, thank you so much for hanging out with me this trip, and hope you enjoy this video. Kind of gives you a little overview of the life in northern Wisconsin. An amazing life. I love it up here. I wouldn't live anywhere else.
I don't mind saying I roll out of bed and I roll up. Ooh, stretch my back and legs. Well, now what did the younger me become? I make some coffee and a plan and I decide on oats and eggs. Natural.
the meadow, nestled by the lake. And in my mind I see you. The earth began to quake. It's this time of winter, I can feel you're near. And if I scream your name out, maybe you can hear. Maybe you can hear.
Came down, I pleaded not to go.
Okay, we are back and on our way to the next stop, I think. Next stop will be probably the feet show at the door. It's usually the next.
Up yourself.
I'm feeling pretty good.
Another beautiful day.
Yeah. Ice is starting to go out in there.
Ice is out on a few lakes already. It's crazy.
Yeah. I'm thinking back to last year and I was out enjoying snowmobiling on the snowmobile trail at this time still.
Oh yeah, for sure.
It's kind of even to get out on the lake. It's like I run all vintage snowmobiles, so it's like I did run the shoreline for a little bit, but a lot of it was doing this one. Full throttle mode. Oh my god, I'm gonna be stuck here all winter.
I know.
Crazy. You gotta take care, man.
Yeah, no problem. Yet or not. I'm gonna go do car wash. If I do marketplace right now, I think I'll do marketplace last this time. Usually I do that first, but not this time. It's a little bit too warm outside. It's almost 50 degrees out there. I always wonder how long it's going to take to get adjusted to paying $9 for a bag of corn. When you remember $4 a bag. I don't think you're ever gonna get used to it. I really should go do car wash though, because that's a $10 bill. The salt off of the car while it's nice out. I think we're gonna do that. We're gonna hit the car wash and then we'll hit Walmart and then Marketplace. Gotta change up the way we do stuff when it starts getting warm out. Golf course straight ahead there. It was like our favorite golf course to do the family tournament at, but they closed. closed it. Car washing. first car wash of the year. Okay, we are done in Hayward. I'm gonna stop at Dairy Queen though on my way out of town. It's afternoon now, so a little bit hungry. Haven't eaten yet today, so that's usually what happens when I come to town. Just end up not eating. Seven outside. Got to lose my jacket. It's a little bit. Not takes a long time to adapt to this. To hot. No, I never adapted to it. I never adapt to it. It's just hot. I don't. If I could stay at 60 degrees, and then go down to where we could snowmobile, it'd be great. Hopefully the Dairy Queen's not too packed. Pretty much gone, so that's good. It was packed here when I went by a little while ago.
welcome to DQ Grill and Show. May I take your order?
How are you doing today?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing pretty good. I'm going to take a double cheeseburger with bacon and pickles only on it.
You want that in a combo or just a burger?
Dude, add some fries with it. I don't need a drink, though.
Okay, anything else?
No, and with the burger, I'm allergic to onions, so if you could make sure it doesn't get around anything where onion to touch for me, please.
Okay, gotcha. You're going to be 11:46.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Have a great day. Until